Hey folks, this is Andrew with RPS Solar Pumps, and I just wanted to take this opportunity to show you guys one of the products that we offer in our store. Right now, we're expanding here at RPS, the RPS campus, and we decided to rehab this little area right here. Looks like it's got a bunch of infill right here, but we're gonna try to make this a nice little place for people at RPS to relax and take some time. So we just did a quick and dirty setup with a pond liner that we installed. We got some sand and we're gonna make a nice little beachy area. The fountain itself turns it over, aerates the water, and also provides an attractive feature and a little soundscape to where we're working. And so this is our RPS solar fountain. It uses a centrifugal pump to drive the water and create the effect. We match it with a fountain nozzle that you can select based on what your preferences are in the shop. Generally, this is about 400 watts of output to the pump, depending on the type of nozzle, the number of orifices, and things like that. You can go for something a little bit taller, more wide, or concentrating more on aeration than the aesthetics. We have this right now turned all the way down. You can also see in the background a lot of cloud cover, so this is not by any means the maximum output of the pump. Generally, you can expect about 2 feet for every two panels that you add to your system, 4, 6, or 8 panels. In this type of setup, we have two ways to do it. We can either suspend the pond and add something buoyant to it and allow the pond, the fountain to aim upwards with a direct shot out from the top of the pump with the nozzle. That's for usually deeper ponds. This is a pond that's only about 2 feet deep. So what we did in this setup was we just put a little 3/4-inch elbow out of the top of the pump, angled it up, and then set it on a stable surface so that the pump is elevated off the liner of the pond. It's not able to roll away or change the angle. A system like this, you'll have to watch the water level in the pond a little bit more. With a floating type of system, all you have to do is tether it and just make sure that the pond level doesn't drop below the maximum height of the pump, which is around 24 to 26 inches, depending on the type of nozzle and everything and how much is protruding above the water line. So I think that's it. If you are interested in learning more about one of these products, please give us a call back, 888-637-4493.